Good morning. It's great to have your company this Tuesday, the 17th of August. My name's Jessica Ramirez, Senior Market Analyst with Bell Direct. Well, just quickly, Breville, Sims Metals Management, SCA Property Group results all beat or met expectations. BHP results ahead, and Australia's biggest lithium company has been born. But now let's touch on overseas markets, where we saw US stocks rise to brand new record highs on their Monday, marking the 49th record close this year. The S&P 500 rose 0.3%. The Dow Jones also rose 0.3%. The NASDAQ went the other way, sipping 0.2%. What's interesting is after Monday's move, the S&P 500 has now doubled from its pandemic closing low. That was on the 23rd of March. So keep that in mind. That's incredible. In other news, don't forget a cryptocurrency ETF will likely soon be available on the ASX within the next 6 months, hopefully. It also comes at a time when the cryptocurrency market is heating up again. The crypto market is now valued at over $2 trillion for the first time since May. Now, importantly, let's cover what to watch today locally. Well, firstly, the futures are suggesting the market will lift a modest 0.1% or 9 points. Keep in mind two things. The financial sector, led by banks, CBA in particular, has started to trend lower. So this is putting a bit of pressure on the market. We saw a lot of technical traders take profits in big banks. CBA shares, for example, their shares are trading lower for the third day. So expect further selling in banks amid lockdowns. On the flip side, we're seeing investors increasingly back investments that have got a green future, i.e. lithium. This is really timely to point out today. Australia's biggest lithium company has been born and will start trading on the ASX today. What do I mean by that? Well, yesterday we saw Galaxy Resources, GXY, they stopped trading on the ASX. Why? Well, the court approved their merger with Orocobre, ORE. So today, Australia's biggest lithium miner and the fifth biggest in the world will trade on the ASX. So it's a combination of ORE, Orocobre, and GXY. So doesn't that put lithium on the map on the ASX? So that's good news there. The second focus, earnings results. What will be a huge boon for markets is that Breville results have smashed the lights out of expectations somewhat. They've reported their best ever sales, $1.2 billion in sales for the 2021 financial year. So that helped Breville report a 25% increase in profits to $91 million. And that was bang on with expectations. So good news there. Secondly, SCA Property Group, they reported their net profit after tax surged over 440%. To $463 million. And that was driven by an increase in the value of their investment properties. This profit result of $462.9 million, let's call it $463 million, that smashed their expectations. The market was only expecting profit of $151 million. So extraordinary results for SCA Property Group, SCP is their ticker. And thirdly, in terms of earnings results out today, Sims Metals Management, SGM, they reported their profit after tax surged about 196% to $229 million. That also smashed through expectations. The market was only expecting profit of $235 million. Other results to watch, BHP is likely to report after the market close. Now, the third major focus today will be commodity stocks. Why? Well, the oil price has fallen for the third straight session. The oil price is slightly starting to regain ground, though, and is trading about 0.3% higher. So the oil price currently at $67.40 US a barrel, while the gold price has gained ground for the fourth session, and it's trading at $1,789 US an ounce at the moment. While the iron ore price has headed south again, it's lost 0.6%. It's now at $166.96 US. The fourth element to watch today, broadly economic news. The RBA meeting minutes are out later today. And lastly, my favourite trading ideas that could be worth a look. Well, I want you to meet Australia's largest general insurance broker. It's called Steadfast Group. SDF is their ticker. They were reiterated as a buy by Citi. The investment house increased Steadfast's price target from $4.60 to $5.30. So why the upgrade all of a sudden? Well, Steadfast is taking over another insurance company called Covermore. And this will not only lift SDF's scale, but also the proportion of brokers that it has. Plus, Citi says that Steadfast, SDF is the ticker, remember, they're leveraged to benefit from an increase in interest rates, which you know is happening. And Steadfast is also expecting to report its fourth year of EPS growth. Citi expects EPS growth or earnings per share growth of 16%. In 2022. So that supports share price growth. Also, don't forget lockdowns allow insurers and specifically Steadfast to reduce their costs. So that's why Citi is loving SDF. And if you're into looking at charts, bear with me. If you're into looking at charts to back up your decision making, you'd see the technical indicators are suggesting that SDF could continue to rise over the next week and months. And that's as indicated by the moving averages and the other technical indicator called moving average convergence divergence. And as for final trading ideas that could be worth a look, bullish charting signals have been seen in PPK Group. PPK is their ticker. PKS Holdings. PKS is their ticker. And Liberty Financial Group, LFG. And that's according to Trading Central. I'm Jessica Ramirez with Bell Direct. Stay safe. Happy trading.